Party a little wet.
What's going on, guys? Rush Voris Outdoors here for a product review on the EcoGear Soul Jam HD Solar Waterproof Speaker. This retails for about $129, and I picked it up at Cabela's because I had some unused Cabela points, and it saved me about $80. So with that being said, the price range on this is $129, and that competes with really a lot of other different speakers too. This is a Gorillabox G-Boom. This retails at $100, but the battery on it is crap, so that's why it doesn't even turn on. Doesn't even work anymore. This lasts about 5 hours. And then on this speaker, this is an Anker little wireless speaker. This lasts like 24 hours on the battery, but I left it in a rainstorm overnight and it no longer works because it's not waterproof. This cost me like $56. But great little speaker, too bad it no longer works. So with that being said, let's get into the unboxing of this a little bit. Here we go. This kind of just slides off. Pretty nice case. Start off with the charging stuff here. Comes with a really nice durable rubber USB cord. All it is a micro USB, so it's like any standard Android or Samsung device that charges it. And with the charging head unit here, this is a 5 volt by 1 amp charger. So if you have like a Samsung Android like I do, this charger is a 5 volt by 2 amp. So it overcharges this speaker. It needs a slower charge because it's got like a 12 hour battery life, and the lithium ion battery in it requires a slower charge, and this charges it too fast and doesn't charge it very well. So use the recommended charger that comes with the speaker. Now to get into the actual speaker itself, the good stuff. Here it is, guys, the little speaker. It's smaller than what I thought it was gonna be. Pictures make this thing seem a lot bigger than what it actually is, but for the size, it puts out a lot of sound, okay? To start off, the height of it, okay, 3.1 inches right here. The length of it is 5 inches, and the diameter of it is 6.1. And you can see that little hole there. It'll actually screw on to my camera mount, which is kind of cool, and I can pick it up and host it around and stuff, which I'll show you when we do the water test. I'll kind of throw it in the shower and see what it's got. Anyways, here's some buttons for you. We got the on-off button. Makes a cool little sound. And the Bluetooth. And it has a little voice communicator for you. The buttons are very rubbery. They're not gonna, they feel very good. When you press them, you can kind of tell that you're pressing something and not nothing. They are extremely durable. This is a very durable little speaker. Covered in rubber. I like the orange grill on it. Just a very durable, well put together speaker. Even the back hatch has a rubber lock on it. You gotta spin it open to unscrew it, and that's your little back port there. You got your audio auxiliary input, your charging port, your master on-off switch, so when you're not gonna be using it for like a winter time or it's just gonna sit in the garage, you turn that off and it saves the overall life of the battery, which is pretty cool. And then you can actually charge things with a built-in power bank. You can charge whatever you can charge from a USB. And this is just 5 volts at 1 amp. So it's not gonna be a super fast charger, but it will charge the majority of mobile devices. So that's kinda cool. And definitely when this is screwed on, it's only watertight once it's locked in. So you gotta lock it in. Another thing that sets this speaker apart is the fact that it has a solar charger on it. This is a very high powered solar charger for its size. This is only 5 inches long right here. and for the size of it. I have other portable solar chargers, and they have massive panels. And for the size of this, this will charge, keep it charged if you were in a survival situation. So with that being said, let's move on to the actual speakers of the unit. This has two forward-facing speakers operating at 10 watts apiece at 4 ohms total. And then it has the bottom-facing little subwoofer on it. I'd say that's, 4 inches or so. It doesn't give you the exact specifications of that subwoofer in the little owner's manual. So I can only assume, since this is 6 inches, this is probably a 4-inch subwoofer in here somewhere. But it is actually pretty loud for the fact that it's a little speaker, and it's waterproof. It's IP67 or 67 resistant waterproof. So it's 100% waterproof. It floats in water, and we will be demonstrating that in a little bit. But for the amount of speakers in it, it's actually quite loud. It has a great amount of bass, and it performs. With that being said, let's get into a little bit of a sound test with it. I got my iPod here. It's extremely cracked. I don't know if you guys can tell. But yeah, it's rough shape. Don't judge me. We are going to just turn that on. And it should connect.
Bluetooth connected.
And it'll tell you pretty much everything. So let's say like you were blind or whatever. It'll tell you whatever's going on with the speaker. Let's just throw some music on here. Let's do a little bit of a bass test. Do a little Taiga, pop it. Turn this down for a second. With any Apple product, you can control the overall volume of the unit.
Walk up in this bitch with 100 grand. Two rollies on my arm, another 100 grand.
Don't turn it down.
Bitch, let the money burn, nigga, no.
It controls the actual.
Fucking doing what she can. Popular, King Kong, killer. T-Raw, the real deal, thriller in Manila. Make a bitch pop, pop pills till it's dinner. She a fucking nympho, that's why I fuck with her. Whistle while you twerk, push the singers. All up in the club, throwing up middle fingers. If you dry snitch, turn a bitch to a hanger. Lay your shit down, now you're planking, I'm saying. 1-2 in the bitch came. Break a bitch heart, pouring out the champagne. Why you over there chilling with the little lanes? You ain't know that my shit bang. Pop a bitch, pop, 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 pop a bitch, pop, 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 pop a bitch, pop, 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 pop a bitch. 1-2 in the bitch came. Pop a bitch, pop, 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 pop.
Step back a little bit. And I'll turn the sound down a little bit, but as you can tell, it's got good sound to it,
good quality sound. And then the bass on it, that song's pretty bassy, so it kind of gives you a little bit of test on the bass of the actual unit. It's actually, when the bass kicks, it's got kind of a wobble to it, and if it's on a silted surface, it'll actually slide off. It'll vibrate itself off. So. Let's go to another song here that is not YouTube copyrighted at all. And this will be kind of a vocal, so you can hear the quality of the speakers. If it was, if you're just listening to regular music. This is Sade, No Ordinary Love. That's a little bit of a sound test for you. As you can see, it's got good highs, great medium, and it's got a lot of low. This speaker has a lot of low end to it. It's not as loud as, let's say, a speaker like this, where it's just got two forward-facing drivers with a little bass booster on the side. This is a much louder speaker than this is, but this kills this speaker in bass. This has very little to no bass, even with the little bass port on it. The bass on this speaker is absolutely unbelievable. So with that being said, we are going to move on to the waterproof test with this one. All right, guys, here we are in my bathroom. I got my speaker on the little tripod that I was talking about earlier. So that's kind of cool how you can mount it onto something or just put it on the ground there. You guys can see that little slot there for the bass to come out. What I'm going to do here is start playing some music and then run the shower down onto the speaker. You should see it. This could kind of simulate a rain test. You could, and then I have a little box full of water. We're going to float it here next. So here we go. Got my iPod. Somebody say that. Here we go, Sade. As you can see, it's already a little wet. Still bumping right now, just bumping. Shit's wet, that's for sure. That's pretty cool. Yep, IP67 waterproof. Keep trying. Definitely worth the buy there, huh? Next, we're gonna put it in a little bowl of water. Next, we're gonna put it in a bowl of water and see how it floats. All right, guys, so here we are with the speaker, with the little tub of water, and we're gonna see if this thing actually can float. Turn that stuff up a little bit. All righty, let's test her out. Pretty cool. Always make sure the back cap is definitely secure. But no, that thing floats. Thing floats for sure. That's very cool. Just playing music. Talk about indestructible for an outdoor lifestyle, huh? Look at that, guys. Crazy. We'll take you back in the living room. With all of that being said, for the price, $129, this speaker is one hell of a buy. You're not going to find that price on a lot of other different speakers for what the bang you get for this one is. And the fact this one has a solar charger. No other speaker has a solar charger. And it's going to charge itself. So if you're an avid outdoorsman and you're always finding yourself, you know, 4 or 5 different days in the backcountry, you either need to buy a speaker with 40 hours of playback time or a speaker that can charge itself or have different ways to charge your speaker. So yeah, guys, I would totally recommend this speaker to anybody who is an avid outdoorsman or has an active lifestyle that wants a shockproof, waterproof, dustproof, and self-charging speaker that really will last all day. This actually has 12 hours of battery life, and then with the solar charger, it'll run forever. So with that being said, guys, go out and buy one. I'll leave a few links in the description below if you like it. I'm not getting paid or anything by this. I just think this is one hell of a speaker. Super stoked about it, and you guys should be too. Anyways, well, thanks for watching. Have a great day, guys. God bless, and we'll see you later.